Today we discuss understanding fractions, improper fractions and mixed fractions. Anytime we do division, like 15 by 3 equals 5. Here 15 is the dividend, 3 is the divisor and 5 is the quotient. Also, when dividend is greater than divisor, here dividend is greater than divisor. At that time, the result is a whole number, that is, quotient is a whole number. In another case, divisor is greater than dividend. In that case, quotient is a fraction. 1 by 2 is a fraction. Here, the dividend is 1 and divisor is 2. So, dividend is less than the divisor. Dividend is less than the divisor, so it's a fraction. Consider the fractions 1 by 4, 2 by 8, 3 by 5, 1 by 5. The fractions 3 by 5 and 1 by 5 are equivalent fractions because their denominators are same. Is 1 by 4 and 2 by 8 are equivalent fractions? Yes, 1 by 4 and 2 by 8 are equivalent. Also, these are equal fractions because 2 by 8 is 1 by 4. How to compare the fractions? Which fraction is greater than? How to compare? If the denominators are equal, then it is easy because if we compare the numerator, we get which fraction is greater. 3 by 5 and 1 by 5. 3 by 5 is greater than 1 by 5 because the numerator 3 is greater than 1. So, 3 by 5 is greater than 1 by 3. Then, how to compare 3 by 8 and 3 by 10? Which one is greater? For that, we take the LCM of denominators. LCM of denominators, LCM of 8 and 10, the least common multiple of 8 and 10. Least common multiple of 8 and 10 is 40. 8 into 5 is 40 and 10 into 4 is 40. So, least common multiple of 8 and 10 is 40. Or we can find the LCM using this also. 8 and 10, the 2 dividing by 2, we get 4 and 5. So 4 into 5 into 2 is again 40. So LCM is 40. We convert these two fractions as denominator 40. The denominator becomes 40 when multiplying 8 by 5. So multiplying the denominator by 5, so we multiply the numerator also by 5. So, 3 into 5 by 8 into 5. If we multiply the denominator, then definitely we multiply the numerator by the same value. Otherwise, the value of the fraction changes. 3 by 8 is equal to 3 into 5 by 8 into 5. Also, 3 by 10. 10 into 4 is 40. So, multiply 4 in the numerator and denominator. So, 3 into 4 by 10 into 4. So, this fractions equal to 3 by 8 equal to 15 by 40 and 3 by 10 is equal to 12 by 40. Now, the comparison is easy because the denominators are same. So, 15 by 40 is greater than 12 by 40. Therefore, 3 by 8 is greater than 3 by 10. In some cases, divisor greater than dividend. Here 4 divided by 3. 4 is greater than 3. But we couldn't express this as a whole number. This value is greater than 1. This fraction couldn't be expressed as a whole number. This form couldn't be expressed as a whole number. This type of fractions is called an improper fraction. Example 4 by 3, 7 by 2, etc. are improper fractions. Convert this improper fraction into mixed fraction. 4 by 3 equals 1 and 1 by 3. 3 into 1 plus 1 is 4, so 4 by 3. Also 7 by 2 can be expressed as 3 and a half. 3 into 2, 6 plus 1 is 7, so 7 by 2. 30 by 8 can be expressed as 3 and 6 by 8. 8 into 3, 24 plus 6 is 30, 30 by 8. Simplify 5 by 11 plus 4 by 3 divided by 10 by 11 into 5 by 11 minus 14 by 33 of 1 and 2 by 7. So 5 by 11 plus 4 by 3 divided by 10 by 11 is same as A by B divided by B by C equals A by B into B by C. Multiply, divide a number means multiply by its reciprocal. So into 11 by 10 into 5 by 11 minus 14 by 33 of 1 and 2 by 7. 1 and 2 by 7 is 7. Plus 2 is 9 by 7. So it is 9 by 7. So 5 by 11 plus 11 and 11 cancels. 5 into 2 are 10. 2 into 2 are 4. So here it is 2 by 3. Minus 14 by 3 into 9 by 7. Next, 5 by 11 plus 2 by 3 minus 7 into 2 are 14, 3 into 3 are 9. So, 14 by 33. Here it is 33. Here it is 33. So, 9 by 33. So 3 is common to both these values. So 3 into 11 is 33 and 3 into 3 is 9. So 6 by 11. So LCM of 11, 3, 11 is 33. So 5 into 3 plus 2 into 11 minus 6 into 3. So we get the answer 15 plus 22 minus 18 divided by 33. That is equal to 19 divided by 33. Decimal fractions. A set of digits after a decimal is called a decimal fraction. For example, 0.67, 0.22, 0.49, etc. are decimal fractions. They are called decimal fractions because they can be converted into proper fraction by dividing and multiplying them by 10 raised to n, where n is a number of digit after the decimal point. Here 0.767. Here after decimal we have 3 points. So we multiply 10 by 10 raised to 3 and divide it by 10 raised to 3. We get 767 divided by 1000. So 0.767 is represented as a fraction 767 divided by 1000. Also 0.49. After the decimal point, we have 2 points 4 and 9. So multiply by 10 square and divide by 10 square. We get 49 by 100. Next is recurring decimals. If in a decimal, some digits or set of digits are repeated continuously, that type of decimals are called recurring decimals. Here 8 by 3, if we divide 8 by 3, we get 2.666 etc. That is the decimal part continues the 6. So we can write it as 2.6 bar. This bar represents 6 is repeating. Also 2 by 3 is equal to 0.666 equal to 0.6 bar. And 16 by 99, that is equal to 0.16, 1, 6, etc. Here 1, 6 is repeated, so put bar on the numbers 1 and 6. 1, 6 is repeated.